Hello everyone and welcome in this fourth video of AnimalTA tutorial, and today we will see how to set the correct parameters for the tracking. I will consider in this video that you have already imported and prepared your videos, but if you have any problems with one of these two steps, I invite you to go to have a look to the others video from this channel. To illustrate today's tutorial, I will use this video of two ships that are inside a fence and moving freely. As you can see, this video has been previously prepared and it's not ready for the tracking. So to select the tracking parameters, you first have to select your video. So you click on your video and as you can see here, the rectangle is now green, which means that your video is selected. Once you selected the video, you have this new button that appears here, which is Prepare Tracking. I press my Prepare Tracking button and you now arrive at the Prepare Tracking panel. In this panel, you can see here the original video and the arena in which your targets are to be found that we previously defined is highlighted here in red. The way this window is working is quite simple. In fact, what you will see here is exactly how the program is working. And the program is working step by step, beginning with this step and then going from top to bottom. So it will do this first step, then this one, and so on. And thanks to this visualization panel, you can see at each step of the tracking process how your program see your videos. For instance, if I'm staying here at my original video, I move through my timeline and I can see how my original video look like. Well, that's quite logical. Now, the first step that the program will do is to change your video to a grayscaled video. Quite simple. At this moment, you have one possibility, which is to add this correct brightness filter. The correct brightness filter is used to remove change in luminosity. As you can see here, we have a big change in luminosity, probably due to the sun because we are outdoors. And to correct this kind of problem, you can press this correct brightness button. And now you will see the moment that I press this, the program will correct my video. So it's still the same frame, but this time the luminosity has been adapted to the rest of the video and we don't have this big change anymore. Apart from the correction of the brightness, you can also correct the flickering, which is an option that you will need if you have flashing lights. For instance, if you're recording with neon light, this might be useful. Then our program will continue and he will make the background subtraction. If you remember in our previous video, what we saw is that we defined a background, which is our video, but without the target. And now what the program is doing is that it's comparing this image without the target with the current image of your video. So what remains is the target itself. When you have a look at this image, you see that we have a lot of black, which means that there is no difference in this part of the video with the background, but you also have some lighter spots which indicates where we have a difference. So basically it's our targets. Then as you can see, this is not black and white. In fact, it's a shades of gray. So you have a very dark gray, but you also have some lighter gray in other images. For instance, if I move a bit, as you can see, it's always my target that appear whiter. But we have something that's almost white here, and we have some dark gray here. Well, all shades of gray. What your computer needs is to determine what is part of the target and what is not. So we will tell him that there is a threshold. If a gray is darker than our threshold, it will be transformed to black. And if a gray is lighter than our threshold, it will be transformed toward white. And this way we will obtain only black and white image. So to do that, we press our threshold. And as you can see, now my program, all the light gray is white and all the dark gray is black. And you can play with this threshold so that you increase the number of white, or you decrease the number of white. The best to do is the objective is to see well your targets without having too much noise in the environment. I can move a bit through my video to see how it will look like at different moments. So this parameter, for instance, seems quite well. We have a little bit of noise, but not too much, and our targets are still much lighter than the rest of the environment. Then we can continue. What we need to do here is to clean all this little noise. So to do that, you have the erosion option. So the erosion is basically reducing the size of all white shape in your image. So if I put an erosion of 1, as you can see, I almost cleaned already everything that was annoying in my image. I can then add dilation, which is doing the exact opposite. And I want, with my dilation, that my two targets are only one single shape. So as you can see here, my dilation is a bit too low. So I will improve it. And like this, we have now two big spots, which are my targets. We still have a bit of noise. We will clean that later. But, and I can move a bit through my video, we always see our targets without problem. So now I want to definitely remove these little points. And to do that, I will indicate in which range of size I can find my targets. So my targets, which are these two spots here, are bigger than, I don't know, bigger than sim 0.1. I advise to always take a bit wider than what you need. So 0.1 seems good because, as you can see, I removed all the noise, but I still see my targets. I can move a bit through the video to ensure that it's working all the time. For instance, here we have a little problem. So it's not a real problem. If you have things like these that appear punctually, it's not a problem for you. But just to make it well, the best we can, I will try to fix this. So let's go back to the previous step. And at this threshold, we can see that we already have a very light part of the video. So maybe I should increase a bit my threshold. Now I increased my threshold, almost removed with erosion, well, come back with dilation. And with arena, well, we removed one of these two white spots. So I will try to make it even a bit better. Maybe being a bit more strong here, not too much because I don't want to lose my target. I could also add a second step. Yeah, that's better. I like this better. So instead of decreasing that one, I will just put two steps of erosion. Then my dilation and my area. And as you can see now, I removed all this noise. I can move a bit through my video, ensure it's always working well. And well, seems now quite well. We always see our two targets. They never disappear. Good. Finally, you have the distance threshold. This distance threshold is a value that indicates how much one target can move between two frames. So it's not easy to set the first time you are doing it, because it will depend on a lot of things. It will depend on your frame rate, it will depend on how fast your animals are moving, and of course of your scale. So to help you to make this the best as possible, you have here two indicators. The first one is a little light blue point, and the second one is a big dark blue disk. So a little light blue point is the current position of the target. So at this image, this 18 image of my video, my two targets are identified by the program here and here. And now the blue disk is centered on the previous known position of the target, which means that if I move a bit, as you can see here, this blue disk center is still centered on the last position of my target, but the little blue point has been moved. And so if your distance threshold is well set, you will never have the little blue point outside of the big blue disk. So you can go a bit through your video and ensure that yes, your two points are always one inside the other. And it seems to be the case. My advice is to always take something bigger than you need, because you don't know, maybe at one moment one of my ship will get crazy and run very fast. So I don't want to have this kind of problem. So I increase a little bit more than I need my distance threshold. Finally, I can also set the number of individuals per arena. So in that case, I know that I have two ships, so I will just put here a value of two. In some cases, you might have more than one arena. In that case, the number of individuals per arena will be the same for all of your arenas. So if you put here a value of two, the program will consider that you have two individuals in each of your arenas. But this can be a bit annoying, because you might have some videos with different numbers of targets in each arena. So to avoid this problem, you have here this little parameter button, and when you press it, you have here a miniature of your video, and you will have the list of all your arenas. So this is my arena number 0. I have only one, but if you have more than one, you will have arena 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. And you can set the number of targets per arena individually. So I can change the number of targets in my arena 0. And if I add more arena, I would be able to change independently the number of targets in my arena 1. As a reminder, you always have here the number of targets associated with the arena. So in this arena, I expect to find two targets. And well, that's it for the preparation of the tracking process. So you can go back to your main menu. You can do this for all your video. If all your videos have been recorded in the same way, you have this, apply these parameters to other videos. So this way you do this step only once, and then you apply it to all your video. I think I will make a little tutorial dedicated to this question of working with a lot of videos. But well, now that we are back to our main menu, we can begin the tracking. So you press Begin Tracking button, select the videos you want to track. In my case, I only have this one. And then let's go for the tracking. So as you can see, it's quite fast, and you can use it for as much as video as you want. So if you have 100 of video, you can select your 100, begin the tracking, and do something else. Well, now that my video is tracked, I will show you the result. So view and correct track. And here we are, I have my two ships that are tracked. And as you can see, the tracking worked quite well. In our next tutorial, we will see how to correct this tracking in case of mistake and how to use all this panel. So I hope to see you next time, and I wish you all a very good day.